Welcome to Between the Covers Summer Series with our spotlight on South Florida. With me is Pranoo Kumar, the owner of Rohi's Readery, a social justice-driven children's bookstore in West Palm Beach. It's a space to make connections and to build community. And I am so glad you are here today and that you took time off from your beautiful store.
Oh, thank you so much for having me today.
Tell us about the concept and what inspired you and what did you want to accomplish with this physical setting?
Absolutely. So Rohi's Readery is actually named after my grandmother, Rohini, and she was an education activist who fought for the emancipation of women's rights and also children's rights. And something about Rohini was that she always wanted to ensure that children felt seen, valued, loved, and a sense of belonging. So I always say that first so that people know really the concept of Rohi's Readery is to just do that. And then my first daughter is also named Rohini. But it is a social justice driven children's bookstore and learning center where we want to ensure that people of all ages feel empowered and unapologetic in who they are. So every book is reflective of historically marginalized communities. So the Black, Indigenous, Arab, Latina, Pacific Islander, Asian, the LGBTQIA plus community, the neurodiverse and disability community, sharing beautiful, joyful, positive stories and truths. And then we do about 15 to 20 free classes a month, like cooking, gardening, dance, music, story time, both for children and adults. So the goal is really to build human connection and really ensure that everyone feels a place where they can come and feel loved.
I don't think the word unique can be underscored enough. Let's look inside of the store for a moment.
Yeah.
What is the criteria for selecting a book?
Oh, absolutely. So, like I said, we want to ensure that we are honoring historically marginalized communities, but really the criteria is ensuring that we are providing opportunities for children to, as we say, be revolutionary readers. So when we say that, we say, we read something, we learn something, we share it with the world. And so really thinking about ways to engage in critical literacy, really meaningful conversations so that children and adults can take what they've learned and apply it to being empathetic citizens of the world. We have books from newborn board books all the way to our young adult and adult section because we found that adults need love too and love to read. So really the criteria is just making sure that everyone has an opportunity for a window and mirror of learning.
I love the revolutionary reader, which
yes.
you're wearing yes. yourself.
Yes.
You know, the pandemic had such an effect on businesses, and independent bookstores just disappear one after another. So the pandemic is when you decide to open this bookstore?
Yes.
Are you just fearless?
Oh my gosh. Well, I have an incredible community and support system, and I think one of the biggest things when opening Rohi's Readery was also trying to fulfill something within because I had just moved to Florida, was trying to find a place and space to build community, had just found out I was pregnant with my first child. And so Rohi's Readery in my mind was, how can we build authentic, loving human connection at a time where we need it most in ways that are also safe and approachable for all humans. So yeah, it's been a journey. I will say the Readery and the walls are just filled with love from the community, and I can't say that enough.
What advice would you have for parents, for educators, who they want to promote diversity in books for their own children?
I love that question. I think just listening to your children, allowing them to be exploratory learners, allowing them to cultivate their curiosity. We say that there is already brilliance within our littlest ones and people of all ages. So how do we tap into that already there brilliance? So by taking them to a bookstore, by taking them to different places that'll allow them to learn the stories of others and hopefully learn more about themselves. My hope is that when people come into the Readery, they feel as though it is a safe place for them to ask questions, to engage in texts, and to learn from each other along the way.
As the kids are getting out of school this summer, you have special events planned?
Yes. We do about, like I said, 15 to 20 free events a month. Actually, one event that we're having coming up is at the Square, and it's going to be called our Summertime Series. And so we're doing a story time, a movement class. We're going to be doing summertime reading readiness, summertime safety with St. Mary's Medical Center. So finding ways to still engage in reading throughout the summer and get kids, you know, engaged in that space so there's no summer slippage.
More revolutionary readers.
Yes, exactly.
Before I opened Rohi's Readery, my career path was?
Medicine, and I decided to switch into education because I believe in identity-driven, empowering experiences.
My favorite book as a child?
I did used to check out Charlie and the Chocolate Factory a lot in this library, but there's so many.
If we could see your bookshelf at home, what would it tell us about you?
That there is a lot of love, curiosity, acceptance, and empowerment in the space, and that there are books everywhere in the house.
Kids' books often have superheroes. If you could pick a superpower for yourself, what would it be?
To be around everywhere where my children are so that I can see them growing up in so many different ways.
Oh, that's beautiful.
Yeah.
And last one, one thing you would tell your younger self?
Be kind to yourself, be gentle with yourself, feel empowered in yourself, and you are more than enough.
More than enough. Pranoo Kumar is the owner of Rohi's Readery in West Palm Beach. This has been such a pleasure. I want to thank you for spending time with me.
Thank you so much for the opportunity. I really enjoyed it.
I'm Ann Bocock. Please join me on the next Between the Covers.